Where we slipped a big time was by feeding Bambi at the table. She was, after all, our very first dog, and none of us, my parents included, could resist those pleading eyes gazing up at like some half-starved waif as we ate. So author here said that because Bambi was our first pet and we don't know that how to upbring the pet and how to take care of them, then because whenever we used to see Bambi, we used to feel like that the Bambi, she was very much neglected and abandoned animal, as she used to show it like the gestures, like eyes. She used to create little sounds whenever they used to eat. Surely it could do not harm to give her a tight bit now then, especially of more unpalatable parts of her meal. How could you eat with those eyes? The limpid pools, Mala used to declare melodramatically, gazing at you like that, the traveling from your plate to your hand to your mouth. So because Bambi used to look at them with the pleading eyes, so they used to give the food to Bambi along with them on the dining table itself. But one day author's sister Mala, she declared melodramatically that how can we eat in front of an animal like this? Whenever we used to take a bite from our plate, the journey that bite covers from hand to mouth, the Bambi, she observes each and everything in a very keen way. That this is not possible to eat in front of the animal. In old days, people used to put aside some of the food in their plates for birds and cows and surely dogs before they ate. So this was really no different. But author and his family, they consider this thing that in old days also the people used to keep food for birds and cows and for dogs as well. So this is not different if we are giving food to Bambi along with us. Sometimes, of course, you were in hurry, late for college or school, and what better and quicker way to dispose the rubbery toast? So whenever we used to be late and we are in a hurry and we can't finish our things, they used to dispose all that things. They used to give all that thing, the left food, to Bambi, of course. And so nearly all her life, Bambi would turn up at the dining table during meal times and sit down, droll and whine, and we tried to eat. He said, so for most of our life, Bambi, because she was our first pet and we allowed her to eat along with us in the dining table, after finishing this her meal, she used to take the rounds of the dining table, and they all tried to eat. Turn by turn, she would go to person looking terribly martyred, as if we refused to give her anything, it would become a 10 times worse than we had the guest. So whenever some guests were there in the house of the author, so Bambi used to repeat the same habit. She used to take the rounds of the dining table, and it appears to the guests like this, that this animal is so poor that its masters, they were not giving anything to her for eating. Knowing full well that she was not liking to get anything from the family, she had sit down next to the guest, look pathetically at him or her as if she had been starved for last fortnight, and start her routine. Whenever some guest used to come inside the house, she tries to attract the guest towards herself by showing her sad face, and in front of the guests she don't accept any kind of food from any family member. She, in other hand, it looks like this to guests that the dog was hungry for last 15 days and they were not giving her anything to eat because in front of the guest, Bambi used to take the things she wants that the guest should offer her something to eat. If this doesn't work, she placed a paw on the guest's thigh and continued whining. Bambi, stop it. Behave yourself. Put your paw down at once. Do you behave like this when you have your food? So in front of the guest, Bambi used to behave like a child. That is that she wants all the love and affection of the guest as if the family members were treating her badly. She used to create sad sounds, low sounds in front of the guest in order to win the heart of the guest. The housemates, they tried their level best in order to stop the Bambi. Bambi, stop it. Don't put your paw on the thigh of the guest. But do you behave like this when you have your own food? But Bambi didn't stop. And then she produced her final weapon. Rolling complexly, she put her dripping chin on the poor guest's lap and looked up sorrowfully, laying down a large swath of silvery drool on the guest's cloth. You know, these cruel people don't give me anything to eat. I'm so hungry. So the Bambi used to create the sounds like sad sounds, low sounds, as if the housemates were treating her very badly and they are not giving anything to her for eating. So that is why she's requesting the guests to do something for her, to offer her something for eating. Bambi, get out, mug out of here. You have drooled all over Auntie's lovely sari. Disgusting dog. Really so sorry. Here is a napkin, or would you like a towel? Damn dog. Here, let me wipe it for you. And if there was more than one guest, she would of course try her luck with each of them. It was the mistake not repeated with the other two dogs that had taught me a golden rule, no feeding at the table ever. So Bambi used to behave in a different manner when some guests used to arrive in the house. She used to first, she tried to grab the attention of the guest by moving around the dining table. Secondly, she tries to grab the attention of the guest by creating sad sounds. Third, she tries to grab the attention of the guest by putting her paw on the thigh of the guest. And final weapon, she used to put her dripping chin. Dripping chin, with the saliva came out of the dog's mouth, so that is why it was dripping. Drops were there, drops of saliva used to fall. So she used to put her dripping chin on the guest's lap, and she used to create low and sad sounds in order to grab the attention of the guest. And the housemates, they feel insulted many times because of Bambi. They tried to, you can say, compensate the guest by saying that, can we clean your clothes with a napkin, or would you like a towel or anything like this? So the author said that with the upbringing of the Bambi, I have learned the most important lesson to upbring the pets, that is not to serve the pets on the table ever. So this is it. Thank you.